Hello. I think I've received a lot of questions about practice, motivation, and stamina. So I'm going to try to answer in short what that means to me and how to develop it, maybe, and how that affects your dancing practice overall. I think I have a very rigorous practice. I think, but that changes with time, also with age. When you are younger, you do move physically a lot more than when you are older. So the practice of dance does not necessarily mean moving for the entire time. It can also mean creating, thinking, reading, collecting literature, understanding. But in your younger years, in your 20s, it largely does mean moving, because that's when your body is available to you. Might as well make use of it to the maximum extent. So I start my day very early. I start at 4. I get up at 4 and I start practicing at 4:30. Almost 3 days a week, and maybe 4 days a week. The other days I'm definitely in the studio by 6 latest. One day I go at 5:30 for sure. So I'm invariably practicing very early in the morning on all days. The only day that I may not wake up so early is a Sunday, and I'll wake up at 7:30 or 8 o'clock. But that's besides the point. The thing about motivation is that it comes from the need to dance, or the need that you have within you to excel in whatever it is that you're doing. It need not only be applicable to dance. I think definitely people in any field, whether it's sports or business or science or economics or architecture, you have to be passionate and about what you do. And that passion itself will drive you to constantly seek avenues of excelling within the field that you're in. I think that with Bharatanatyam as an overall practice, I recommend doing other things to support your dancing practice. Very often we think that dancing itself gives us all the stamina and strength and flexibility. That is not the case. There's no tennis player or swimmer or runner in the world that doesn't cross train. I don't know why dancing should be unique in that sense. So if you want to be a skilled Bharatanatyam dancer who has your body available to you, you must do some somatic technique, either yoga or Pilates, to work on awareness of your body and alignment. I also believe in strength training. I think that's very important. You can do strength training in many different ways. You can just go to a gym. You can. I don't recommend lifting weights unless you have somebody to guide you. But you can do strength training with your body. There are many things that do that. You go to your nearby gym and find out what they have for strength training. I also think that you need to do something that has cardiovascular, builds your cardiovascular strength. I run. If I am unable to run, or it's bad weather or too late at night, I use a cross trainer, or you can bicycle or swim. Something that keeps your heart rate up is also important. So we need three things to be fit overall: flexibility, just general muscular strength, and cardiovascular strength. I think all three are important to be a strong dancer. And to answer the question about stamina, you have to push it slowly. If you do 5 minutes of nritya continuously, do 8 minutes next week, and then do 12 minutes, and then do 14 minutes. Very often as dancers we think that the energy will come on stage. That's not true. You do have adrenaline, you do have the audience watching you, and you do feed off of that energy, definitely, I don't deny it. But at the same time, raw physical energy you get only by training. And I truly believe that. It's not that you suddenly have the muscles on stage when you don't have them in your studio. So please try to build them and work consistently. There is no remote way that I can teach you this. Find a teacher near you and take their help. It's very difficult to do it on your own. make your teacher help you, and I'm sure you will be on the way to building stamina and strength again.